the parable of Puranjana. Bahisat, son of Havirdana, was a great emperor. He was learned in all the Vedas and the Karmakanda thoroughly. He performed many sacrifices. Every sacrificial Yajnashala started from the margin of the previous Yajnashala, and thus he covered the whole of the country and so was called Prachina Barhi. He had 10 sons called Prachetas. He directed them to undertake the propagation of the human species. So they first wanted to do tapas and were going near a very big and beautiful lake where perfect peace prevailed. Strangely enough, they saw Lord Shiva coming out of that lake with his retinue. They prostrated to him and he sang a song in praise of Sri Narayana and asked them to do tapas by repeating it and attain the state of birthlessness. Accordingly, in the very lake, they began their tapas and reached the supreme state. Narada approached Prachina Barhi, their father, and remonstrated to him for performing such sacrifices by which all the animals killed by him in the sacrifices would be waiting for his arrival in the next world with horns of steel to tear him into pieces as soon as they see him. Prachina Barhi submitted that he could not understand what Narada meant and requested him to kindly explain his views on a lower level. So Narada began the famous allegory, parable, called the story of Puranjana and taught him the way for liberation. Once there was a monarch of great renown by name Puranjana, Jiva. He had a friend by name Avignata, the unknown, the God principle or Ishvara. Dva Suparna Sayuja Sakaya, Munduka Upanishad. He was so called because he could not be known by the ordinary means of knowing. Puranjana searched for a pleasing abode throughout the earth, but could find only one city south of the Himalayas in the Bharatavarsha. It was called Bhogavati, the body hutment of enjoyment. Bhogayatanam. The city had 9 gates and the 9 apertures on the body, 7 on the high levels in the head and 2 in the lower level in the pelvis. It had defensive fort walls made up of the 5 elements. It had many varieties of luxuries and grandeur desirable. There were parks, bazaars, etc., sense objects. In one beautiful garden, the emperor saw a young and attractive damsel by name Puranjani, intellect disposed to sensuous enjoyments, with 10 attendants, 10 indriyas, and one general by name Brihadbala, the mind. One serpent was protecting her like a bodyguard by name Prajagara, the prana. It guards the city even when the whole city is asleep. Puranjani was in quest of a husband. She was beauty incarnate with many ornaments and a dress fit for a princess. The emperor could not resist her attraction. He made advances, inquired who she was and her errand, and finally she accepted him as her husband and told him that he could occupy the city and enjoy all sense pleasures for 100 years. The city was the place where from man could aspire for religious merit or sense enjoyments or please their ancestors or even roam about like animals. It is the asylum for householders, ascetics, mains or gods and all living creatures. Thus, mutually agreed, they entered the city and enjoyed all sense pleasures for full 100 years. Puranjana lived in the palace like a henpecked husband, just imitating the queen. If she eats, he eats. If she laughs, he laughs. If she weeps, he weeps. If she drinks wine, he also drinks wine. Thus, completely deluded by the queen, he forgot his own real nature and was helpless. One day he went out for a hunt, attended by his general Brihadbala, mounting his car body, drawn by 5 horses, organs of action. He went to the forest called Panchaprastha, sense objects, The car had two wheels, good and bad karma. Three flagstaffs, three gunas, five cards, vital airs, one single rein, mind, one charioteer, intellect, and a seat for the owner, heart. It was capable of five kinds of motion, sense perceptions. He left the queen behind in the palace and began to hunt. He killed a large number of animals, both wild and otherwise. He was badly fatigued and exhausted. He felt hunger and thirst and returned home, had a bath, felt refreshed, dressed up well, smeared fragrant perfumes and went to meet the queen. He felt her separation very badly, inquired about her, felt distressed to hear that she was lying on the ground on account of his absence. The queen was happy to see him back and began to praise his good qualities. He came back to remain in her sway. Both embraced. Thus living a happy life, they had 1100 sons and 110 daughters. They were all duly married and each son had 100 children. They lived in Panchala, sensuous objects. By that time, old age had set in on this couple. The chief of Gandharvas, celestial musicians, was called Chandavega, terrible speed, the time factor, who ravages all cities with 360 male Gandharvas and an equal number of female Gandharvas, days and nights of the year. Chandavega had a daughter called Durbhaga, an unbearable, the time spirit, whom everybody hates, and a son called Bhaya, fear. And Durbhaga was married to Prajwara, fear of death. Prajwara and Durbhaga, roaming about in the world, came to the city of Bhagavati. Puranjana had loved it very much by feeling I and mine. He resisted their attack, but of no use. He became a prey to them and suffered great agony. He felt wretched due to the pressure of Chandavega. He lost his power of discrimination. He saw the city falling, sons, grandsons, servants and ministers rebellious and disrespectful, wife cold and indifferent. He reluctantly decided to quit the city. Chandavega became furious in devastating it. Prajwara, Durbhaga and Bhaya together began to set fire to the city. Gross body. The bodyguard Prajagara, Prana, when he found that the city was set fire to by Chandavega and his followers, jumped off the city like a flying serpent and escaped. The emperor, with a strong feeling of I am the body and the consequent attachments, felt wretched for having to lose the palace, the queen, sons, daughters, grandsons, sons-in-law, daughters-in-law, servants and treasury, etc. But he could not help. He pitied his wife, who would be helpless thereafter. She was very helpful to him and was depending on him for everything. Perhaps she might also die along with him. The poor children would have no one to protect them and they would die like flies. When the serpent guarding the city, Prajagara, Prana, left off, the city became ashes. In all these troubles, Puranjana had completely forgotten his old friend and companion, Avignata. On account of the strong attachment which he had developed for his wife, Puranjana was born again as the daughter of the king of Vidarbha and was called Vaidarbhi, Jiva, as a seeker of spiritual knowledge. Vaidarbhi was married to Maledvaja, king of Pandya. She begot one daughter and seven sons. Agastya married the daughter and the sons ruled over the southern regions called Panchala, sense objects. Maledvaja, having handed over the kingdom to his sons, resorted to the forest to worship Lord Krishna. His wife followed him. He started tapas, eating leaves and grass, and was emaciated. He conquered the pairs of opposites, heat and cold, hunger and thirst, pleasure and pain, and became a Samadarshi. He controlled all desires, controlled the senses, the breath, and the mind, became pure externally and internally. He identified himself with Brahman. lost consciousness of the body and the external world. He was initiated into true knowledge by Srihari himself, and thus he realized himself to be the witness for all the actions of the body, senses and the mind. He realized himself to be the all-pervading self, and thus lost contact with the body, that is, died. Vaidarbhi was looking on her husband as God himself. She was emaciated, and with her locked hair and tattered clothes shone with the lustre of her austerities like smokeless fire. She found her husband seated motionless, not knowing that he had left it long back. When she found the body cold, she became perturbed and cried like a doe. She found herself friendless and miserable. She collected fuel and placed the body on it and set fire to it and decided to enter the fire along with her husband. That very moment, her old friend Avignata appeared as a Brahmin and began to console her. "Good lady, who are you? Whose daughter are you? Who is that man that is dead? Do you know me, your old friend? Can you remember me as Avignata, whom you discarded when going in for sensuous pleasures? You and I are the swans, inhabitants of the Manasa Sarovar. We lived there for thousands of years. Leaving me, you came to the plains for carnal pleasures. You saw the city Bhagavati with pleasure gardens and nine gates, the merchants and marketplaces. Then you saw the beautiful lady Puranjani, and you fell into her snare, forgot your divinity and the teachings of the scriptures. Her association has brought on this downfall and wretchedness to you. Really, you are the master, the self. You are not the daughter of Vidarbha, nor that man your husband. Your wife was not that Puranjani. You are neither man nor woman. You are the Hamsa, the swan. You are me. I am you." When admonished thus, the original swan regained self-consciousness, which was lost due to the friendship with the body and its lower tendencies. Thus, this parable denotes that the Jiva is no other than the Supreme Self, Paramatman. Hamsa plus Aham plus Saha, Hamsa. I am he, the Brahman. Aham Brahma Asmi. He is neither male nor female. Associated with sensual tendencies, he suffers a downfall in the city of the body and suffers samsara. With the spiritual tendencies, he gets the association of saints, approaches the self and knows himself to be Atman, suffers nothing but ever remains in joy, in a state of Sat-Chit Ananda. Having heard such lessons and having cleared all his doubts from Narada, Prachina Barhi gained the supreme knowledge, repaired to Kapila Ashrama, performed great tapas and finally merged in the self.